إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbi Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Al-Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Al-Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Al-Islam. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our tafsir classes. We're still working with Surah Yasin. And this is Surah number 36, and today, inshallah, we'll be working with verse number 69. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون اتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون. Verse number 69. وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين. وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين. وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين. وما, this is for negating effect, article to negate something. وما and not. علمناه, the verb علما, to teach. علمناه taught him. We have not taught him. الشعر poetry. وما again negation, nor ينبغي. ينبغي is it befitting. Befitting, the word to fit, to be suitable. له, to him. In هو, إن شور هو إت إلا except ذكرون reminder وقرآن مبين plain. We understand that the kuffar of Mecca and the mushrikeen, they start to label the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam different labels, and also they start to lie against the Quran. And when you have something good and you don't want people to pay attention to it or to follow it, that you need to give a label, make up some labels and apply it to the man or the product that he presenting. So sometimes they talk about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being a sahir, a magician, majnoon, mad, touched by the jinn. And sometimes they talk what? About the Islam itself or the Quran. So one of the things they talk about the Quran, that this been copied from other books, or this is an ancient tale. Okay? And also they label the Quran to be a shi'r, to be a poetry. Although they know that is not poetry, because they are also the people who had mastered this work, and they used to say poetry, and they even compete with one another with poetry. So they know that the wording of the Quran and the way how it lay out is not a shi'r, is not a poetry. Okay? They know this, but why they saying that? To try to find doesn't matter, you understand? All what you need to give a bad propaganda about something. Doesn't matter if it's correct or not. The main thing that labels something with a bad name or give it bad image so that people can turn away from it. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is saying concerning the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ الشِّعْرَ. We did not taught Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam الشِّعْرَ, poetry. وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ. It doesn't even fit with Muhammad to say poetry. That means even if he tried, he could not. We understand that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was illiterate man. He could not read or write, but he was smart, intelligent. But Allah made him to be ummi, literate, so nobody would say he copied from other books. How he can copy it and he could not write? Okay? Or that he read others' books and now he transferred this information to us. He could not also read. So the same thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give him the ability to say or to put together poetry. So anything that it will lead to suspicion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had removed it out of the way, so the people did not have excuse why they did not believe in Muhammad or the message of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah is saying that we did not teach Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by no way that what he's saying can be a poetry. Okay? So what he's saying is not a poetry, neither he been taught, and even if he tried, he could not do it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him unable to do this. And all this for one main reason, that the people have no valid excuse not to follow the Quran and follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Neither it is fit to him to do so, neither he's capable to do it. إن هو إلا ذكر. Indeed, since the Quran is not a poetry, so what it is? Allah telling us that saying that إنه ذكر is a reminder, okay, to teach the people and to remind the people what happened to the nations before them. So remember, because if you transgress and you disbelieve, the same thing can happen to you. So it is a reminder. It tells you about what's going to happen in the hereafter. It's a reminder. It's teaching you. And what else? And it is a Quran, and is not only a reciter, but mubin, clear, واضح, obvious, okay, is have rules and regulation and have direction and guidance. So Allah negating the Quran, the fact the Quran to be anything other than a dhikr. It's for purpose of reminding the people about Allah, teaching the people. And also it is a Quran, a reciter, and it is mubeen, is a clear, okay, to show them guidance. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. In huwa illa dhikrun wa Quranun mubeen. وَمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ الشِّعْرَ وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ وَقُرْآنٌ مُبِينٌ. And we have not taught him, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, poetry, nor is it suitable for him. This is only a reminder and a plain Quran. Wa Quran mubeen. Okay? What is the purpose of the Quran and the revelation? It comes to the next verse, verse number 17. لِيُنذِرَ مَنْ كَانَ حَيًّا ويحق القول على الكافرين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين لينذر. The purpose of the Quran is inzar, is a warning. Okay? Is a warning. That means some people, they go with their glad tidings, and some people, they need to put fear in their hearts to warn them. That means if you did not do so and so, now the result will be such and such. Okay? Inzar. And the person who is doing the inzar is what? Is nazir, munzir, doing inzar. This was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to give a warning. Alright? Man kana hayyan, man who? Kana is or was hayya, living. وَيَحِقَّ and may justify القول, the saying or the word or the decree, على, against or upon, الكافرين, the disbelievers, rejecters of the faith. So this verse is telling us why the Quran came down and what's the purpose of the Quran. لِيُنذِرَ مَنْ كَانَ حَيَّا, to warn those who are living. And here we are not talking about living in a sense that you can move around and you can breathe and eat and sleep. We're talking about the real life of the heart. Because if you have a heart, now you're going to be benefiting from the Quran. If your life, if your heart is a life heart, a living heart, Surah number 36, verse number 70, لِيُنذِرَ مَنْ كَانَ حَيًّا. So everybody is living in physical way, but we're talking about the heart, because the heart acts in ibadah, acts on worship of Allah, acting on submission to Allah. So if your life is alive, is your heart is alive, Now this going to be has effect and impact in you, this Quran. But those who have aided, those who have aided heart, is not going to benefit them. They only see the dollar. They only understand the value of the dollar. Only see the dunya. Okay? So those people are dead, not physically, but in their heart. Alright? So now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the Quran to be an evidence against them. Will be because the Quran, حُجَّةٌ لَكَ أَوْ عَلَيْكَ. The Quran is an evidence for you or against you. So if you did not follow the Quran, so now Allah had established already an argument against you. He sent the messenger and he sent a book, reveal a book. So now your argument with Allah. What you going to say? I didn't know. I didn't hear about it. I didn't read it. Was so much expensive I could not buy it. Okay? Quran became available in all languages. Translation. Okay? And in many places now the Quran has been given free. Even now became on the internet. You understand? All what you need to go and write, you understand, Quran.com or Quran.net or whatever, will give you the Quran. Alright? So now if you are not, so now you have no argument with Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَحِقُّ الْقَوْلُ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. Because Allah already knew before that so and so is not going to believe, but nevertheless Allah sends the Quran, so he have no excuse after they say, I didn't know about it. I never heard about something called Islam or Quran. Okay? So Allah made it available. Okay? So now the Quran will be a evidence against him. Okay? So the Quran to invite and to warn those who have a solid heart that accept the advice and the truth. And also the word of punishment will be against the kuffar and justify against them. Okay? Because they didn't want to humble themselves and to accept Allah to be the Lord and to accept Islam as a way for them to live by. Alright? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, that he or that he or it Muhammad may give warning لِيُنْذِرَ مَنْ كَانَ حَيًّا. Because even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he have a limited time, and after this he die, he's a human being. But it's still what? The Quran is still there. Okay? So the Prophet can give the warning, and the Muslim can give the da'wah, but still the message is there. You don't want to accept it? It's there, but don't say that was not available. I didn't see it, I didn't hear about it. Alright? So it may that this Quran became a warning to him who is living, a healthy minded, the believer, and the word charge may be justified against the disbelievers. Alright? Verse number 71. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا خَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ مِمَّا عَمِلَتْ أَيْدِينَا أَنْعَامًا فَهُمْ لَهَا مَالِكُونَ. أَوَلَمْ ما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون. أولم. Do not. It's like a question, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yarau, see, witness, anna, that we created khalaqna from the verb khalaqa. Okay, khalaqa means create. Khalaqna, we have created. Lahum, for them. Mimma, of what? عملت أيدينا, that our hands had made, أنعاما cattles, فهم they are لها, to them مالكون, possessors, owners, right? Do they not see that we have created for them of what our hands have created, the cattle, so that they are their owners? Why is the people going too far? Why they disbelieve? Why they could not see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was no help of anyone or anything that He made for them? And you see the word for them, lahum. Allah doesn't need a camel. Allah doesn't need a horse. Allah doesn't need any of this milk. Alright? Allah doesn't need meat or flesh to eat. But Allah said that He created for them an aman. Cattles, camels, cows, and sheep, all these things, okay? And فَهُمْ لَهَا مَالِكُونَ, they own it. They did not make it, but they own it. And they have the ability, you understand, to have them, to have control over them. This itself is supposed to be a sign to them. Is something exists? What a mother nature can make a cow? Show me, let the mother nature make another cow. I'm going to stand here and I want this water or the river or this palm tree. I want a cow come out of it. Since he's telling me that God is the mother nature.
Mother nature.
I want to see this.
Okay?
So why you could not see that Allah and no one other than Allah? Did Isa alayhi salam, Jesus say, I created this? Did anyone claim? You see, the crazy thing, people attributed things to others. Talking this about the mother nature did, Jesus did, you understand, such did. But why they did not claim what? The only one making the claim is Allah. No one until now stand up and say, I created the fly. Because no one dare, because they know that somebody will challenge them. Okay, show me how you make another fly now. Forget about the elephant, it's too big for you. Make a fly.
A little teeny weeny fly.
Yeah. Show me, you understand, that you can even stop this fly of stealing your food. Or even make poo-poo in your food.
Can't stop.
You see? With all this big body and all this movement and after this and do like this and come back again. By the time you go, it'll fly. You see? So Allah say, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا. Why they don't see? Why this does not bring them and wake them up to worship me and me alone? That we have created for them. Because they are the one who need it. Okay? And amen. And we give them the ability to own it, to possess it. And see after this is saying what? وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون. And this word, you need to think about it also. تذليل, make it submissive, okay? Make them submissive, okay? To such a degree that you're able to ride on them and even to eat their meat. Look how big is the camel. Subhanallah. And look, a little kid can tell the camel, nikh, down like this, the camel will go down. And the little kid will go on top of the camel. And he said, get up, go, or whatever, yalla, to get up.
Yalla.
More than this, it listens to you alive, and even when you're about to take their life, Allah gives you control over them. Yes, they fast a little bit and do this stuff, but he kills them and he eats their meat. So Allah makes us leave. Who a human being can fight something you understand like a camel? The height of it is about 2 times of you. The weight about 5-10 times like you. The sizes, all the things. But is Allah say, I am the one who made it submissive for you? Mm-hmm. How you can you deny this?
No.
You could not. And even your ride, can you deny this? They didn't say no. And even you're ready, you want to eat it and slaughter it. You lay down there and you slaughter it. And فَمِنْهَا ذَلَّلْنَاهَا لَمْ فَمِنْهَا رَكُوبُهُمْ وَمِنْهَا يَأْكُلُونَ. Alright? Was not this only. Say in the next verse. وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا مَنَافِعُ وَمَشَارِبُ أَفَلَا يَشْكُرُونَ. وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا مَنَافِعُ وَمَشَارِبُ أَفَلَا يَشْكُرُونَ. And for them, وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا, in the cattle, مَنَافِعَ, benefits. So it's not a matter of only riding and eating. Allah say, no, you do a lot. And you benefit a lot from it, okay? He says a lot of benefits. And you drink from them milk.
Halib,
okay? And after this Allah say, أَفَلَا يَشْكُرُونَ. Why you shouldn't be grateful? Why you could not be grateful to Allah? He make it submissive for you. He make it a right for you. He make it a means of eating. And make benefits.
Close.
And make drinks. And the word benefit itself, like he said, is many things that under the word benefit.
Mm-hmm.
Look, you can make from the wool.
Mm-hmm.
You make, you understand, you crochet and you do things.
Mm-hmm.
You can take the skin. You make a prayer rug. You can make the skin, you make shoes, okay? You can take the skin and make a water sack. Name it, this is only about one thing. You take the bones and you do different things from it, okay? You make combs, you make different things, you understand, from the bones of this animal and thing, okay? Manafi', a lot of manafi'. Some of them, even that you get it for the beauty of it, to enjoy looking at them.
Mm.
So the benefit is a lot. So at the end of all this, Allah said, why they don't be grateful?
Mm.
And the first way to be grateful to Allah, to acknowledge His oneness, to acknowledge being is the true only God, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The shukr is not only saying Alhamdulillah, because you can say a word, but your action is different. You say Alhamdulillah, but you like somebody learn a word in Arabic. Alaykum as-salam. You say a word in Arabic, Alhamdulillah, and after this, you're not really about Alhamdulillah, because you heard the word in Arabic, you repeat it. But you still say Jesus, okay, in Jesus' name, or you understand this, okay? So this not shukr, you are not grateful to Allah. You are not grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says that all the things that Allah give you is supposed to what? To bring you to what? To be grateful to Him. To be thankful to Him. To acknowledge Him. And to acknowledge Him, not as a giver only. Acknowledge Him as the only one worthy of worship. Okay? Let's see the verse. Do they not see we have created for them of what our hands have created the cattle so that they are their owners? And we have them into them. So that they saw that some of them they have for riding, and some they eat, and they have others benefits from them, and they get milk to drink, will they not then be grateful? Okay? And right away Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? In the next verse 74. وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً لَعَلَّهُمْ يُنصَرُونَ وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً لَعَلَّهُمْ يُنصَرُونَ. And this right away show you that most of the human beings are not grateful to Allah. How? By shirk. Associating partner beside Allah. Attakhadhu, that means they adopt or they talk. Okay?
Yet they take for other
people. Yes. Wattakhadhu, and they have taken min dunillah, other than Allah or beside Allah, alihatan, gods. Huh? Why? La'allahum, maybe, yunsaroon, help. Okay? They talk other than Allah for purpose of helping them. Victory, protection. Okay? لَعَلَّهُمْ يُنصَرُونَ. And maybe. Okay? Because how can be idol is something that you did with your own hand is going to help you. Could not even move from its spot. Huh? How is it going to help you? Or a dead man. He's a sheikh, he's a wali, he's a saint, but he's dead. Even if he's alive, he's still a human being like you. He could not do too much to you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he himself, he could not benefit you. He can admonish you, he can invite you.
Call.
This nothing but call, not call. Call it, call. Okay, say. Alright. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying what? لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون. سبحان الله. لا يستطيعون في الاستطاعة to be able, capable, okay? That these gods and this aliha, this idol, they took it to be helpful for them. Allah says they could not help them. لا يستطيعون, they did not have the power or the mighty to what? To give them help or victory. وهم لهم جند محضرون. And they themselves are standing to watch and to protect their gods. You see how silly it is? They told the gods so it can help them. But you standing defending your God. Why don't let your God, you understand, make the argument instead of you?
So they don't security for the God.
So they don't understand. Okay? But originally they take them because they're going to benefit us. They're going to bring us closer to Allah. But why are you defending them? Let them defend themselves. Why are you standing there watching, making sure that nobody understands? Huh?
Do nothing to their God.
Subhanallah. Okay? وَهُمْ لَهُمْ جُنْدٌ مُحْضَرُونَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying here, فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ إِنَّا نَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ إِنَّا نَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. So here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah addressing him.
Say,
don't worry about this. Okay? Alright? لَا يَحْزُنْكَ. Don't let this.
They speak.
You understand? Don't let your talk, your accusation, label in the Quran to be shi'r, and all these things. Don't know, Muhammad, don't let these things affect you or make you sad. Okay? Because we are well acquainted that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, well acquainted with what? With their secret and what they say in public. That mean is a warning. I hear you, I see you, I will deal with you. Okay? So Muhammad, don't worry about it. Let them. They call you mad, they call you majnun, they call this shi'r, poetry, all these things. Don't let this bother you. Keep with your mission. Keep with your da'wah. Okay? Because that we already acquainted, we hear them about what they say, saying, regardless if they say it among themselves or they publicize it outside. Okay? We are aware about it. Inna na'lamu, we are acquainted, we hear, we know. Ma yusirruna, from sir, secret, wa ma yu'linun, to publicize. Okay? They could not help them, but they will be brought forward as troop against those who worship them at the time of the day of judgment. So let not their speech then grieve you, O Muhammad. Verily, we know what they counsel and what they reveal. Then this will be, inshallah, starting a new chapter or new paragraph about أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الْإِنسَانُ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ فَإِذَا هُوَ خَصِيمٌ مُبِينٌ. Inshallah, we'll continue next week and will be the last class for Tafsir Surah Yasin. And inshallah, basically, sorry to make this announcement, or our classes from now on is not going to be what you call official time, okay? Because the absence and the lack of participation. So, if we show up and there is no class, I'm sorry, okay? I could not sit waiting for half an hour for a student to show up. So from now on, anytime you want to come, before Aisha, 45 minutes, sit down. If there is a class, alhamdulillah. If not, grab a book and educate yourself. Okay? So if it happens that I give a class, alhamdulillah, there's no class. Because you understand, I think I try to drag it as much as I can, especially we about, you understand, approaching Ramadan, and we need to start to get into business and get things. I have a big load on me. I could not be waiting for people dragging their feet to the classes. This is not going to work with me. I have the summer program now. I have to focus on it. I have a couple of books I try to finish, and so I take my time to prepare the class and do study and investigate things. And after this is nobody, so it doesn't make sense. Inshallah, try to finish the class for Tafsir, which is going to be next week. And for the marriage class, maybe we have one or two more. We're going to finish them. Other than this, is no promise. Okay? If I feel up to give it. If not, this will be it, inshallah. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, and Allah.